The bright lights, they're hard to take, you know, but... All right, so yeah, I am from Miami, and I do love being from Miami. It's a great thing. And today I'm going to be... how many of you were here last year before I even get started? Okay. Well, thank God the weather's cold, because otherwise you guys wouldn't be here. I mean, how many new things you think there is that I'm going to tell you from last year, because it's sort of the same lecture, right, about how to do a medical consultation? I mean, I'm sorry. It's not what anesthesiologists want to hear. It's the same. Matter of fact, that's going to be, you're going to, I added some stuff, though, that's interesting. There's one study, actually, on this that was published that's brand new that will be, I will be excited to share with you. But other than that, I'm going to be repetitive, but that's okay, because at least in my own practice, I can tell you we've made no progress at all in getting meaningful consultations. So some things are worth repeating. Okay, I got it. We started my timer. They're saying, you're off in 30 minutes. We better get rolling. Okay, so what are we here to do today? Number one, for those of you who, how many of you are not anesthesiologists? Excellent. So I'm going to remind you, for those of you who are here, what we actually do know, what you can tell us that we need to know, and understand what makes the difference between a good and a bad consultation, the impact that that may have on perioperative outcomes. Again, there is actually one study that was published. So you may say, what is this a picture of? Well, this is actually me out on the water, and that's, you know, if it were any warmer out, that might be you out on the water. As a matter of fact, if it were any warmer out, it might be me out on the water, and you guys could have just, you know, read through my slides. But the most important thing any consultant can do is actually tell you about whether or not someone has really good exercise tolerance. Once you answer that question, you can skip the rest of this lecture. But assuming that you can't always get a great history in that regard, there are some things that we need to know. So why do a consult? To tell someone what they already know? Obviously not. You want, in the Rumsfeldian medical lexicon of consultation, you want to know what they know that they don't know. That's often what's written down. But sometimes you have to add what they don't know that they don't know. And how many of you are surgeons in the audience? Oh, good. I'm not insulting anybody.